boxing history have needed rivals to test themselves against, though. For Eubank, that man primarily was Nigel Benn. Different style of fighter, a very different personality, but for a while in Britain, he was the man.
Every time I step in that ring, I'm ready to put my life on that line. Because that's how much my titles mean to me. I'm not here to lie down. If someone batters me from pillar to post, I will get up. I don't care if I'm injured or whatever. No one is taking my title away from me.
Right hand! There he's found it! And Malinga's down in round five! This is why this man, Nigel Benn, gives you excitement and raw adrenaline every time. Just when he looked in terrible trouble, he found that punch. What a fighter this is. Oh, good right hand. First from Benn, an even better one by the look of it from Malinga. And the right hand seemed to be a slip. Just a slip, it looked like to me. Well, he's counting that as a knockdown. Benn is complaining that it was a slip. The corner are in absolute uproar about that. That could be absolutely crucial. There goes the bell to end it. Malinga smiles. He's lifted aloft. Benn's corner men hug him. They're not even pretending that they've won it.
I'm not going to make up any excuse. But now it's time to call it a day. All I can say to you, Caroline, will you marry me?
I like living on the edge. I thrive in pain.
Hitting me is a waste of time. I don't feel pain.
Left hook gets through from Benn. Nice and elusive there. Two of them exchanging.
I went to throw a big right hand and I went down badly on my left foot. I have a weak ankle and I don't have to make that excuse.
As far as I'm concerned, I was in the process of knocking out Nigel Benn. But he went over and twisted his ankle and that took the opportunity away.
He says he's all right, takes more than that. But Collins senses here that Benn may be there for the taking for a moment.
Maybe I could have gone on, but he's giving me another shot because he knows if he wants to beat Nigel Benn, he has to beat Nigel Benn properly, not on a twisted ankle, and that's what he wants.
I got a no-win to say, this is it, man.
For years to come, they will always remember Nigel Benn as the most exciting fighter in the history of British boxing. Just when they thought Nigel was finished, he'll always come back, and believe me, I know from experience, I've been in there with him.
I tried my best for 10 years, I've been giving you every bit of excitement. Don't judge me on one fight. I thought I had it in me, but I'm still the same person you met 10 years ago. I haven't changed. I tried to do everything I set out to do, be number one, give you everything I've got. I can't do it no more, and now it's time to call it a day. Thank you all for supporting me. Thank you.
By any yardstick, it became an exceptional career, but how much do you respect a man, Glenn, who nearly, remember, early in the decade, found his career going away from him? He rebuilt himself, didn't he?
He did rebuild himself, and he rebuilt it very well indeed. He is a fighter who come back, but I think the thing we remember Benn for was he was dark and he was brooding, but he was full of fight. You know, he was exciting. The public loved him because he'd always give his all, and sometimes he wore his heart on his sleeve, but that's what you liked about him. You know, he showed everything.
There was electricity in the air every time he fought, but Barry, this thing about rivalry, which is such a feature of boxing, the rivalry with Eubank and Collins, looking back now, how do you tie the three together and assess them?
Well, it's difficult, and I don't want to disparage any of them. They were all great fighters. For me, the most attractive and the most exciting fighter to watch was Nigel Benn. He was exceptional. I think Steve was a brilliant fighter in his own sort of strange method. Very tough, very durable. Again, Eubank had that sort of enigmatic style, didn't really work a lot through quality punches rather than quantity. But they all had their specialties, and for me, Nigel Benn was the most attractive of them all.
Ian, do you look back and think this was actually one of those golden periods that one will remember later in life?
It was a great era, that. It really was a great era for the super middleweights, wasn't it? And Benn was the British Mike Tyson, wasn't he? He was a volatile character. He could be so moody. He used to say, I had the angel on one shoulder and the devil on the other. You never knew how you were going to find him. Personally, I thought he was just electric in the ring. Mm-hmm. I think, to be honest, at the end, some of those fights we saw there, that was the worst of Nigel Benn. His peak was when he fought Gerald McClellan. He was just sensational.
After the break...